Yes. Okay. Am I audible to you all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Could you be able to see the slides?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Coming to the heart chambers, the heart got divided into four chambers: upper two atria, which we also call it as receiving chambers, and lower two ventricles, which we call it as pumping chambers. Heart is divided into right and left halves by septum. We call that wall as septum. So for example, in this picture, you can able to see. So this is right atrium and this is left atrium. This was separated by a septum, means by a wall called interatrial septum. Okay. And next, this is ventricle. So right ventricle and left ventricle. These are separated by a septum called interventricular septum. And these septums are actually closed. There is no any holes or nothing will be there. If there is any hole or anything, that will be closed by the surgery. And next, the septum between the right atrium and right ventricle, we call this as in atrioventricular septum. This side we have the right atrioventricular septum. This side we have the left atrioventricular septum. And but these septum have the walls. The right side we have the tricuspid wall, and the left side we have the bicuspid wall. And in this slide you can see about the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, about the atria, right atrium and left atrium. For this left atrium, the receiving vein is the pulmonary veins. So these are the pulmonary veins. So there are a pair of pulmonary veins. Coming to the ventricles, we have the right ventricle and the left ventricle, which we also call it as pumping chambers. This has the thick myocardium. So you can see in this picture also. And blood will be exist in the ventricles into the arteries. From ventricles, the blood will go into the arteries. The arteries are nothing but aorta and pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery from the right ventricle and aorta from the left ventricle. So this is the true heart. So the real picture of the heart. You can see here, this is the right atrium and this is the left atrium. And this is the right ventricle and this is the left ventricle. And this actually we call it as papillary muscles. And this is cardo tendine. And these are the cusp. This is bicusp. Two cusp will be there. Here we have the tricusp. And here also we have the papillary muscles. If we have two cusp here, then we have the two papillary muscles. Here we have three cusps, so we have the three papillary muscles. And this is aorta. This is a semilunar wall, which is present at the entry of the aorta to control the flow of the blood. And this is interventricular septum. This is interatrial septum. And this is right atrioventricular septum. This is left atrioventricular septum. So coming to the heart walls, we have four heart walls: tricuspid, pulmonary at the entry of the pulmonary artery, mitral on the left side between the left atrium and left ventricle, aortic at the entry of the aorta. So these are actually the gates to control the flow of the blood. Without walls, there will be the backward flow of the blood. To prevent the regurgitation, we call that as regurgitation, which is backward flow of the blood. To control that only, we have the walls. So first one is tricuspid. Tricuspid is present on the right side. So we have three leaf-like structures. So that's why we call it as tricuspid. And this is cardo tendine. And this are the papillary muscles. So on the right side, we have the three papillary muscles. So which actually will prevent the backward flow of the blood from the ventricles to the atrium. And pulmonary wall. So this is the pulmonary wall, which is present at the entry of the pulmonary artery. This walls will look like a half moon shape. That's why they named it as pulmonary artery. And pulmonary wall or the semilunar walls. This also will prevent the backward flow of the blood from the pulmonary artery to the right ventricle. And mitral valve. So we also call it as bicuspid valve or mitral valve. that actually has two leaflets, and this is cardiotendine, and here we have the two papillary muscles. This wall will actually prevent the blood to flow from this left atrium, from the left ventricle to the left atrium. So anywhere, if you have a wall, that will prevent the backward flow of the blood, nothing but regurgitation. And aortic wall, that is also a semilunar wall, which looks like a half moon shape. That is also present in the entry of the aorta. So this also will prevent the blood to flow from the aorta to the left ventricle, to prevent this backward flow. So these are the walls. This is the pulmonary wall, or the semilunar walls. You can see it looks like a half moon shapes. And this is aortic wall. These are also looks like half moon shape. This is tricuspid wall, and this is bicuspid wall. We also call it as mitral wall. This is actually the transverse section of the heart. And you can see in this picture, this is coronary artery. Even the heart is also an organ. It also needs blood supply. So from the aorta, we will get these arteries. And these are the coronary veins that will drain the blood into the right atrium. And what is the path of the blood? We already have seen this. So I'll tell you one more time. So you just join these things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So first one. So the right atrium will receive the blood from superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. And it goes to the second point. The second point is the right ventricle. So from the right ventricle, it goes to the pulmonary artery for oxygenation purpose. After completing the oxygenation, the blood will come to the pulmonary veins. From the pulmonary veins, it goes to the fourth point. This fourth point is the left atrium. From the left atrium, the blood will go to the left ventricle. And from here, the blood will go to the aorta. So the sixth point. So from the aorta, it will go to the all the body parts. This is circulation of the blood. In this circulation, we have two loops. One is pulmonary circulation and other one is systemic circulation. And systole and diastole. So what is the normal blood pressure? Anyone? What is the normal blood pressure of our body? Yeah, anyone? What is the normal blood pressure? Anyone? Hello? Am I
already? 120 by
80? 120 by 80. Actually, in biology, 120 by 80 was very good. That was the good answer, but that is not the best answer. So the best answer is 120 by 80 mm of Hg. In biology or in any medical group, you have to tell along with the units. Because it's not like simple number, okay? But
okay.
Good. 120 by 80. 120 by 80 mm of Hg. For example, if you want to tell the heartbeat, just it was a knowledge question, knowledge thing only I'm sharing you. If you want to tell the heartbeat also, it was 72. You should not tell it as a 72 like that. 72 beats per minute. If it is respiratory rate, 16 to 20 breaths per minute. So likewise, only you have to tell the number along with the units. That is very important in biology. Because in biology, we have an approximations. So we can't tell the exact point. Okay. Okay. So what is systole and what is diastole is? So as she told, 120 by 80 is the blood pressure. 120 is the systole. Systole means the highest recorded pressure during one heartbeat. And diastole. Diastole is the lowest recorded blood pressure in one heartbeat. Diastole means relaxation, when the heart will be filling with the blood. Systole is the contraction phase, when the blood is pumped from the heart to the arteries. So this we call. So systole is the highest. 120 is the systole. Numerator is the systole and denominator is the diastole. So conduction system of the heart. I'll show you the picture. So in most of this cardiovascular system, so the explanation will be wholly with the picture only. If you understand that, then the topic will be very easy. So how the heart will beat, that is the topic with the conducting system. So this we call it as pacemaker of the heart. We also call this as sinoatrial node, SA node. Okay, so SA node. And this is the AV node. So the SA node to the AV node. AV node means atrioventricular node. From here to here, we have a fibers. We call this as internodal fibers. These are the internodal fibers. From here, the pathway will go as bundle of His. So this is bundle of His. And these are the bundle branch. So this is right bundle branch and this is left bundle branch. So the right bundle branch will go to the right ventricle. Left bundle branch will go to the left ventricle. So it will give the branches. From here, we have the branches called Purkinje fibers. So SA node, AV node. SA node to the AV node is the internodal fibers. From here, we have the bundle of His. Bundle of His will go to the interventricular septum. From here, we have the right bundle branch and left bundle branch. So right bundle branch and left bundle branch will give to the branches called Purkinje fibers. Now, the electricity will given to the SA node. From here, it passes to the internodal fibers to the AV node to the bundle of His to the bundle branch, bundle branch to the Purkinje fibers. Likewise, the heart will be beats. So by putting the electrical stimulus to through the nerve, from here, the contraction will start and finally it will spread to each and every chamber. Likewise, the heart will beat. So this we call it as conduction of the heart. Especially the very important point is this SA node. SA node we call it as pacemaker of the heart. And this is ECG. So this this wave, we have only three waves for the ECG. This wave we call it as P wave. And this wave we call it as QRS wave. QRS complex. And this wave we call it as T wave. Okay. So what is P is? P is atrial systole. So the contraction of the atrium. And QRS complex is ventricular systole. Okay. This is atrial systole because atrium is very small. So it gets only smaller wave. And this QRS complex is ventricular systole. So ventricles are very bigger. So it needs the larger time. So huge amount of electricity to stimulate. So that's why the wave is bigger. And next is T wave. T wave is ventricular diastole. So systole means contraction. Relaxation means, so diastole means relaxation. And where is atrial diastole means, atrial diastole will be there in this QRS complex only. Because it will go along with the ventricular systole itself. So P, QRS and T wave. These are the three waves we call it as ECG. You can count the number of heartbeat also by counting the number of QRS complex. So one, two, likewise, you can count the heartbeat also. So per minute, this many heartbeats got recorded, likewise. So this is ECG. So blood vessels. We have three types of blood vessels. One is arteries. Arteries will carry the blood away from the heart. Capillaries are the smaller blood vessels, which will be present inside the tissue and inside the organ. Veins are the blood vessels which will bring the blood towards the heart. And lumen is the empty space present inside the blood vessel. So arteries. So arteries are usually thick walled, that is made up of smooth muscle, which is not under our control. That can dilate and that can constrict. Dilation means enlargement, constriction means narrowing. So arteries will travel throughout the body and it gives branches. So we call that as arterioles. OLE is the smaller artery. If you add a suffix called OLE means the smaller artery. And in this picture, you can able to see this is artery, which is thicker. And it has three layers also. Endothelium, so tunica media and tunica externa. Here also, which is, this is vein, but it is thinner. So this is tunica externa, tunica media and endothelium. And for the veins only, you have the walls. But artery, we don't have the wall. And this is capillary. This capillary is very smaller blood vessels having only single layer. So that single layer is endothelium. So these are actually embedded inside the tissues. So for the arteries, which always carry the oxygenated blood, except the one artery, that is pulmonary artery, which carries the deoxygenated blood to the lungs. But aorta will carry the oxygenated blood to all the body parts. and coronary arteries that supplies to especially the heart muscle called myocardium. And these are the coronary arteries. This is coronary artery, this red color one. These are the branches from this aorta. And these are the coronary veins. This will drive into this right atrium. And capillaries. Capillaries are very, very small and thin blood vessels. And that was the connecting point between artery and vein. First, artery. Aorta will divide into arteries. Arteries will divide into arterioles. Arterioles will divide into capillaries. Capillaries will unite to form venules. Venules will unite to form veins. Veins will unite to form superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Usually from the capillaries only, the oxygen, carbon dioxide will diffuse and whatever the contents are needed will go out to the tissues from the capillaries. And veins. Veins are actually very thinner than arteries. It has low blood pressure than the artery. And also by squeezing the skeletal muscles, so the blood will go into the veins very easily. And the smaller veins, we call it as venules. If you add ULE as the suffix, that means the smaller veins. And veins that has veins to, so veins always will carry the blood towards the heart. Always the veins will carry the deoxygenated blood except the one vein, the pulmonary vein, which carry the oxygenated blood towards the heart. So this blue color thing is the veins. And blood pressure. So blood pressure is the amount of pressure accepted by the blood on the vessels. We call that as blood pressure. We have several factors which affects the blood pressure. One is elasticity of the artery. If the artery has good elasticity, then we have more blood pressure. If the artery elasticity was decreases, then we have less amount of blood pressure. Diameter of the blood pressure, blood vessel, if the diameter got increases, the blood pressure will decrease. If the diameter got decreases, then the blood pressure will get increased. Viscosity of the blood. If blood is more viscous, more blood pressure. If blood is less viscous, less blood pressure. Volume of the blood. This is also directly proportional. High volume, high blood pressure. Low volume, low blood pressure. Amount of resistance to the blood flow. If amount of resistance got increases, more blood pressure. If amount of resistance decreases, less blood pressure. And so we already know ventricular systole and ventricular diastole. Systole is the highest recorded blood pressure and diastole is the lowest recorded blood pressure. So numerator is the systole and denominator is the diastole. 120 is the systole and 80 is the diastole. Okay, let's see the world building part. Angiogram. Angio means blood vessel, gram means record. So record of blood vessel. Angitis, inflammation of the blood vessel. Angioplasty, surgical repair of the blood vessel. Angiospasm, involuntary muscle contraction of the vessel. Always spasm means involuntary muscle contraction. Angiostenosis, narrowing of the vessel. And aortic, pertaining to the aorta. Arterial, pertaining to an artery. And arteriole means smaller artery. Arteriorexis, which means ruptured artery. And atherectomy, surgical removal of fatty substance. Atheroma, fatty substance tumor or growth. Atrial, related or pertaining to the atrium. Interatrial, in between the atrium. Cardiac, pertaining to the heart. Bradycardia, a state of slow heartbeat. Electrocardium, recording the heart electricity. Cardiomegaly, enlargement of the heart. Myocardial, pertaining to the heart muscle. Cardiologist, heart specialist. Cardiorexis, ruptured heart. Tachycardia, a state of fast heart. Coming to the next thing, coronary, pertaining to the heart. Phlebitis, inflammation of the vein. Vascular, pertaining to the blood vessel. Valvoplasty, surgical repair of the valve. Valvulitis, inflammation of the valve. Valvular, pertaining to the valve. And venous, pertaining to the veins. Venule, which means smaller vein. Venogram, record of the vein. Ventricular pertaining to the ventricles. Interventricular pertaining to in between the ventricles. So, vocabulary part. Okay, we'll continue with the remaining part of the vocabulary and this thing on Monday. Okay? Till here it was very fine.
Baba.
Yeah, hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, we'll continue the next thing on Monday. By default,
okay, ma'am.
On Sunday, you don't have any class. So,
okay.
Nandini, Mahitin, and Gokul, it will get completed on Monday.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so you can move to the coding class.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, any doubts?
Ma'am, could you please share the PDF, ma'am? Yesterday also.
Yeah, yeah, I'll share you the both PDF. Blood and lymphatics. Blood and lymphatics and
cardiovascular.
Okay, I'll share you the PDF.
Okay.
Thank you. You can take leave.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye.
Thank you. Okay.
Bye.